Hello, Nopes. So we have started a new podcast for auditory listeners and it will be available on every major platforms. Please kindly hit the follow button and subscribe our YouTube channel for the daily updates. Precocious puberty. Precocious puberty is reserved for girls who before age 7 invites or menstruate before the age of 10. Causes: GnRH dependent 80%, that is complete, central, isosexual, or true. Constitutional, the most common cause. Juvenile primary hypothyroidism, CNS lesions about 30%, like tumor, trauma, any infections such as tuberculosis, encephalitis, etc. Incomplete, premature telarche, premature puberky, and premature menarche. GnRH independent, precocious puberty of peripheral origin, excess estrogen or androgen, ovary, granulosa cell tumor, theca cell tumor, Leydig cell tumor, chorionic epithelioma, androblastoma, McCune-Albright syndrome, adrenal hyperplasia, tumor, liver hepatoblastoma, iatrogenic estrogen or androgen intake. Diagnosis: meticulous history taking and physical examination. True precocious. Constitutional type is the most common one, but the rare one is to be kept in mind. The diagnosis is made by history of early menarche of mother and sisters. The pubertal changes occur in orderly sequence. Tanner stages. No cause could be detected in majority of 90%. Basic investigations for evaluation of a girl with precocious puberty. Serum HCG, PSH, LH and prolactin. Thyroid profile. Serum estradiol, testosterone, 17-OH progesterone, dehydroepiandrosterone, that is DHEA, USG, CT or MRI of the abdomen and pelvis to rule out pathology of ovaries, adrenals or uterus, skull X-ray, CT scan or MRI brain to exclude intracranial lesions like hypothalamic hematoma, electroencephalogram, X-ray of hand and wrist, non-dominant for bone age. Acceleration of growth is one of the earliest clinical features of precocious puberty. Premature telarche. The breast buds enlarge to 2-4 cm. Somatic growth pattern is not accelerated. Bone age is not advanced. Nipple development is absent. Vaginal smear shows negative estrogen effect. Breast bud enlargement may be an isolated event or as a continuum of GnRH-dependent precocious puberty having follicular activity. This child needs periodic follow-up. Premature puberty. It may be due to adrenal or ovarian or central nervous system disease. As such, the investigations are directed accordingly. An ovarian enlargement may not be palpable clinically. Examination under anesthesia or sonography is helpful. USG, CT or MRI scan is required to detect ovarian or adrenal tumor. Estimations of serum 17, alpha hydroxy progesterone, DHEAS and serum testosterone are to be done in suspected cases of adrenal pathology hyperplasia, or if nothing abnormal is detected, then the diagnosis of idiopathic puberty is made. Treatment. The treatment depends upon cause and speed of progress of the disease. The exogenous estrogen therapy or its inadvertent intake should be stopped forthwith. Constitutional or idiopathic. The goals are: primary hypothyroidism needs thyroid replacement therapy to reduce gonadotropin secretions, peripheral action of sex steroids, skeletal maturation to protect the girl from sex abuse. Pharmacological therapy. GnRH agonist therapy is the drug of choice in cases with GnRH-dependent precocious puberty. GnRH agonist therapy suppresses FSH, LH secretion, reverses the ovarian cycle, establishes amenorrhea, causes regression of breast, pubic hair changes, and other secondary sexual characteristics. This drug is safe and effective. It should be continued till the median age of puberty. Dose depot forms: Goserelin or Leuprolide. Medroxyprogesterone acetate 30 mg daily orally or 100 to 200 mg IM weekly to suppress gonadal steroids. It can suppress menstruation and breast development but cannot change the skeletal growth rate. Danazol. It produces amenorrhea and arrests breast development but there is no effect on growth rate of skeletal maturation. Surgery. Cortisone therapy for adrenal hyperplasia and surgery to remove the adrenal or ovarian tumor eliminate the excess source of either androgen or estrogen. The intracranial tumor requires neurosurgery or radiotherapy. Duration of therapy, usually up to the age of 11 years from the period of diagnosis. You have to note that individualization should be done. Thank you all. Have a nice day.